Hello, welcome to SS Unitech. Sushil this side, and this is continuation of SSIS tutorial. So today we gonna discuss about character map. So what is character map and how we can use it? So character map is used to transform input characters. This transformation operates only on column data with string data type. If we have any another data type except string data type and we want to use the character map to transform the input data, then we cannot use the character map to transform the input data. Next is, the character map transformation can convert the column data in place or add a new column to the transformation output and put the converted data into that new column. If we want to change our string columns data to upper or lower case or many more formats, then it helps us. So mainly we use lowercase and uppercase. Rest of the formats are based on the language specific. So here we can see we have flat file source and we have OLEDB destination. So we want to transform our input data by using character map, then load our destination. Let's have a look of flat file. So this is our flat file. As we can see, we have first name, middle name and last name. And we want to convert these three fields because these fields contains the string data. So we need to convert with uppercase then lowercase. Let's have a look of table. Go to on SSMS. So here we can see we have the same number of columns, ID, first name, middle name, last name and date of birth. Once we execute, then we can see we don't have any data at yet. Now go to on SSDT to create the package. So create a new package, right click on this SSIS package, then new SSIS package. Here we need to rename this package with character map. So this is our character map. Now we need to use data flow task inside the control flow panel, then double click on this data flow task. So it will directly move to data flow panel. Inside this data flow panel, we need to use our source, transformation and destination. So our source is flat file source. So we need to use flat file source. We can drag and drop, then double click on this flat file source. Then we can see flat file source editor window will be opened where we need to make the connection. So flat file connection manager. At yet, we don't have any connection manager. So create a new connection. Once we click on new, then flat file connection manager editor window will be opened. Here we need to select our flat file. Here we can browse. This is our folder and this is our file. We can select this file, then click on open. Once we click on open, then this is delimited file. Go to on columns, comma delimited. We are okay with it. We have ID, first name, middle name, last name and date of birth. So we have total 5 columns. As we can see, we don't have uppercase or lowercase. We have the mixed uppercase as well as lowercase, but we want to load the data into uppercase in our database. So click on OK. Retain null values from the source. Go to on columns. We want all the columns, then click on OK. We have done our source. Now we need to configure our transformation. So our transformation is character map. So we need to drag and drop this character map transformation. Then we need to connect with source. Now double click on this character map. So here we can see first name, middle name, last name. So we want to convert these three columns. Here we have option to create new column or replace our existing column. So we want to add a new column. We don't want to replace our existing column. Operation, what we want to do. Here we can see we have a lot of options, but we want to use uppercase. So click on OK. Then again uppercase. For last name, we want lowercase. So we can select lowercase. Then click on OK. Here we have the output alias name. We have copy of first name, so we can rename with new. For middle name we can also use new, and for last name we can also use new. Now click on OK. Once we click on OK, then we need to configure our destination. So our destination is OLEDB destination. So we can drag and drop this OLEDB destination, then connect with character map. Now double click on OLEDB destination. Create a new OLEDB connection. As we have already made the connection, so delete this connection and create a new connection. Here we need to select our server name. So this is our server name. I am going to use Windows authentication, so there is no need to enter user ID and password. Here we need to select our database name. So this is our database name. We can test our connection. Connection succeed. Now click on OK. Again OK. So we have done our connection manager. Now we need to select our table. So our table is character map table. Go to on mapping. As we can see, by default it has been mapped with old columns. So we need to map with new columns. So first name goes to first name. New middle name goes to middle name. Then new last name goes to last name. Now click on OK. So we have done our package. Now we need to execute our package. So 5 rows should be inserted in our table. Now go to on SSMS and execute our select statement. As we can see, first name, middle name, it contains the uppercase, and in our last name we have the lowercase. So we can use according to our requirement. So these are the formats available, which is based on language specific. It also allows us to select the multiple options for a single column, but we have certain limitations where we cannot use the multiple options. For example, we cannot use uppercase and lowercase at a single time. Second, hiragana and katakana, we cannot use at a single time. Next is half width and full width, we cannot use. Next is simplified Chinese and traditional Chinese, we cannot use at a single time. So thank you so much for watching this video. If you like this video, please subscribe our channel to get many more videos. Thank you so much.